Attitudes are considered a major influence of consumer behavior. As such, marketers spend a lot of time and resources in the effort to understand consumer attitudes. Attitudes play a critical role in the consumer decision-making process. I'm Catherine Ngahu from SBO Research, where we do market research. Majority of our clients tend to pay great attention to consumer attitudes. In this video, I will talk about how attitudes influence consumer behavior and decisions. This information is useful for business people, marketers, those in sales, as well as students of business and consumer behavior. The power of attitudes to influence behavior is well acknowledged in various fields, not just marketing. Think of your own attitudes and how they influence the decisions you make in life. In the study of consumer behavior, the topic of attitude is considered critical to the understanding of the psychology of the consumer. It's one of the psychological processes that influence consumer actions. That is together with concepts like motivation, perception, and consumer personality, as well as learning. So attitude sits right there in between as a major factor in the psychological influences of consumer behavior. Attitude is important for marketers because it affects the consumer selection process, how consumers learn, the intention to buy, and the final buying decision. Attitude is important for marketers because it affects the consumer selection process. It also affects how consumers learn, the intention to buy, and the final buying decision. Attitudes influence consumer behavior, particularly in the stage of evaluating alternatives, as well as in making the final choice on what to buy. Therefore, attitudes held by consumers play a key role in the success or failure of a company's marketing strategies. Research shows that positive consumer attitude tend to correlate with success in the marketplace as defined by higher usage, higher market share, or even higher profitability, while negative attitudes, or what we call unfavorable attitudes, are associated with the lower market share, lower usage, lower performance overall in the marketplace. Attitude research, therefore, has been used to study a wide range of strategic marketing issues or questions, such as it's been used to determine whether consumers will accept proposed new product ideas, to gauge why a firm's target audience has not reacted more favorably to a new promotional theme, to learn how target consumers are likely to react to a proposed change in the firm's packaging, brand name, or product size. Now, what are attitudes? Attitudes are an expression of inner feelings that reflect whether a person is positively or negatively predisposed to something. For example, in marketing terms, it could be a product, a brand, a company, a service, and the like. Consumer researchers assess attitudes by asking questions or by making inferences from behavior. Attitude research is used for testing acceptance of a new product, new ideas, testing reaction to new packaging or promotion. You could test attitude towards many aspects of marketing, whether it's your advertising, your pricing, your retailer, and the like, and even online services and e-commerce outlets can be tested for attitude and are all impacted by the attitudes that consumers hold. Attitudes are learned. Actually, attitudes are learned predispositions, meaning that there's general agreement that attitudes are learned, something you learn. The other thing to note is that while attitudes may result from behavior, they are not synonymous with behavior. They reflect a favorable or unfavorable evaluation of the attitude object. As a predisposition, attitudes have a motivation quality. That is, they might propel a consumer towards a particular behavior or repel the consumer away from a particular behavior. So they could propel them towards a product or against it. The second thing from this definition is that attitudes have consistency. Attitudes are relatively consistent with the behavior they reflect. However, they are not necessarily permanent. And though consistent, they do change in certain circumstances. Attitudes occur within a situation and therefore are also affected by the situation. A specific situation can cause consumers to behave in ways that are seemingly inconsistent with their attitudes. Clearly, when measuring attitudes, it's important to consider the situation in which the behavior takes place in order to avoid misinterpreting the relationship between the attitude and behavior. The three important components of attitude come from the theory of the tri-component attitude model, which suggests that there are three important aspects of attitude to consider. First is cognitive, meaning knowledge or awareness. This aspect looks at what do people know? What are they aware of? What perceptions do they hold about a product or service? The second one is the affective component, and this talks about feelings and emotions, and it covers the questions like, how do the people feel about the product or service? How do your consumers feel? What feelings do they have about your product or service? The third is cognitive, which talks about action, the action tendency. This represents the question related to the likelihood of behavior or how the person is likely to act in a certain situation, the action tendency. In attitude research, this is assessed with a question about the likelihood of buying, which generally tends to measure intention to buy. So for example, somebody could ask, when this flavored coffee is introduced in the market and placed in the shop where you regularly buy, would you say that you will definitely buy it, probably buy it, definitely not buy it, or probably not buy it, and stuff like that? When you ask that, somebody is able to respond by telling you their intention in the event that product became available in the market. So it's used to gauge the intentions that people have with reference to a product, a service, a retail outlet, or an online establishment, and the like. Different terminologies are used by different sectors to talk about this issue of consumer attitudes. So many times, marketing people in the private sector will talk about usage and attitude, or what they generally call U&A. Actually, many students, when they go out to work, they are left a bit confused, because when they hear somebody talking about U&A, they wonder, what is that? But U&A to mean usage and attitudes, which basically captures the three factors of awareness, usage, and feelings. In the non-governmental sector and international sectors, like if the World Health Organization would start talking about the attitudes that people hold towards the new proposed vaccines for the pandemic, they will talk about knowledge, attitude, and practices. Because in the non-governmental sector, that is a common language for these three aspects of attitude: knowledge, attitude, and practices. To refer to the same, knowledge for awareness, attitude for the feelings and the like, and practices for the behavior or action tendency. So you have to check which sector are you communicating to in order to know exactly how to refer to these three factors. Actually, in the non-governmental sector, they also sometimes summarize and call it CAP. Just like in the private sector, they talk about U&A, in the non-governmental sector, they talk about CAP. They say, we want to do a CAP study. And you might actually wonder, what are they talking about if you don't know what this represents, or if you come from the private sector orientation. So you have to consider who you are talking to if you are to communicate effectively on this question of the tri-component aspect of attitude. You know, are you private sector focused? They will focus on consumers. NGO sector focused? They are more interested in using this philosophy to test behavior change. That is, for example, to get people to stop smoking, to stop drunk driving, or also maybe they may want to encourage some practices, like I think now they will want to encourage adoption of a product like the vaccine that is coming for coronavirus. They may want more people to agree to take that vaccine. And that kind of thing, just like, again, the non-governmental sector. And if you think of the international sector, the World Health Organization, they created communication to encourage people to wash their hands, to sanitize, to keep social distance, and to wear a mask in order to control the spread of coronavirus. So all of these are ways where this concept of attitude applies. So the three factors to consider in assessing attitudes are: first is knowledge or awareness or perceptions, second is feelings and emotions, and the third is practices or action tendency or behavior. Do like this video and share it with someone you think might benefit from it. So keep watching. Thank you and all the best. We all need to elevate our mindset at this time.